Okay, so we are now going to discuss the third phase of the community organizing participatory action research. The third phase is the community research phase. Community research phase, main objective is problem identification. We are going to conduct your COPAR in order to address the community problem that will be identified together with the community people. So these problems are the existing problems in the community that can be solved through COPAR. So what are the main objectives under your community research phase, which is the third phase of your community organizing participatory action phase? Number one is the formation of research team. So formation of research team. So formation of research team, guys. Under this one, ang gagawin nila is your participatory action research. So if you want to know about the discussion, kindly please check the link below, okay, sa ating below ng ating sa ating description box, okay, ng video na ito. Okay, so that you will able to know what is participatory action phase. So basically, your research participatory action research na gagawin sa community is just a research, but it's not a highly technical research comparable now or comparing now to the research that we are doing in the academe or in the school and in the other fields of education. So itong research phase na to is we are going to use whatever resources we have in the community. And we talk about resources, we have your 4 M's, the manpower, money, machineries, and materials. So this includes now the community people, which is the manpower. So sila ang gagamitin natin to conduct the research and whatever customs, cultures, and traditions they have in the community that can be utilized in order to address the community problem, yun po ang gagamitin natin, okay, as part of the research na gagawin natin. So basically, this is an action research. We will try to look for a solution that would solve now the community problems that are existing in the community. So another activities is research team training. Of course, this research team, okay, since community people po ito mga to at hindi nga natin alam kung nakagraduate pa sila ng college, especially kapag hindi sila nakagraduate, we need to provide trainings for them. Okay, we need to provide trainings for them in order for them to learn about the about it, and of course tulungan natin sila kung paano mas mapapadali yung trabaho nila when conducting now your research. Aside from that, okay, we are going to perform now or do your community validation. Your community validation, or also known as your actual study or the diagnosis or community diagnosis. So, yung community diagnosis, i-identify natin yung problem sa community. If it's a community health status problem, a community health resource problem, or a community health-related factors problem. So, that is basically the diagnosis we are going to use as part of the community research phase. So if you want to know more about that community diagnosis, I do have a separate video of that. Typology of nursing problem in the community health nursing plan. Okay, so iba po siya sa problem na na-identify natin kapag gumagawa tayo ng family nursing care plan. And of course, iba po siya during the actual research na ginagawa natin in the community. So in this one po, ang gagamitin natin is we're going to identify the problem if it's a community health status problem, a community health related factor problem, and a community health resource problem. And we also going to conduct now your prioritization of the problem. So mamaya, i-discuss natin yan. So summarizing of results. So basically, whatever data we have collected during the pre-entry and your entry phase, we are going to present now, okay, summarize now these results and put it into tables or graphs. Then we're going to present this to the community people. So kung matatandaan nyo, the main, the step-by-step process ng paggawa natin sa community in the diagnosis is that number one, we collect the data. Okay, collection of data is the pre-entry and the entry phase. Then we're going to collate now the data. Collation is the summarization of the results. So whatever data we have collected during the pre-entry phase and the entry phase, we're going to summarize that using your tablets, tables. And your using your tables and using your graphs, and of course narrative for reports naman po for mga descriptive data. And after we have collect that, so that's the collation part. Collect, collation. Then the next one is presentation. Yes, you heard it correctly. It has to be presentation first before analysis. Why? Because the community needs to know the data that we have collected. And in the community organizing participatory action research, it should be a collective decision-making. We have to involve the community people in terms of decision-making because in the first place, we want them to become independent. Now, at the end of the Copar process sa kanilang community, the community is already independent and self-reliant to conduct now their own Copar. Okay? So, presentation of results, solution, and recommendation. So, yan, i-present natin sa community. So, ito po yung mga data na na-collect natin during the community duty on pag-iikot po namin together with the research team po na galing din po sa inyong community. So, ang number 1 po ay ito, number 2 ito, number 3 ito, number 4 ito. So, sa tingin nyo po, among sa lahat ng problema yan, alin sa tingin nyo ang dapat nating solusyonan? Okay? At ano ang na-identify nyo na problema at ano sa tingin nyo yung kailangan ng immediate solution, okay, from the community people. So, yan po yung ating gagawin. Then, so sa tingin nyo po, ang problema is number 3. Ano sa tingin nyo ang dapat natin gawin para masolusyonan natin ang mga problemang yan, okay? So, we're going to, that is basically knowing the social concerns of the community. So, kung makikita nyo, in the prioritization of community health nursing problem, there are 5 criterias, okay, na gagamitin po natin. So, if you don't know yet about that 5 criteria, that is the nature of the problem, of the community, of the problem, the magnitude of the problem, the modifiability of the problem, preventive potential, and the social concern. If you don't know yet about that topics, kindly please access the video, which is the prioritization of nursing problem in the community. I have already made a video about that. Okay? Now, basically, during the presentation, ang inaalam natin dito is the social concern. Social concern po kasi, that is the perception of the community towards the identified problem. So that will be able to score it kung zero man siya, kung hindi nila na-identify na problema. Kung na-identify man, pero sa tingin nila hindi kailangan na immediate attention, ang score niya is 1. Pero sa tingin nila, kung na-identify nilang problema and they think it needs an immediate attention, their score is 2. So that's your social concern as one of the criteria in the prioritization of nursing problem. So bakit ko sinasabi yon? Kasi nga, the last part of the community research phase is the prioritization of community needs or problems for action. So basically, hindi natin masusolusyonan lahat agad-agad yung mga problem na na-identify natin during this phase. But we can do prioritization so that we'll be able to prioritize at least several of those problems identified by the community research team and decided by the entire community, okay, using now the criteria that have set, okay, which can be accessed actually sa book ni Maglaya. Thank you for Maglaya for giving us those information, by the way. Okay, and with using that prioritization criteria, we'll be able to identify which problem among the all identified problems ang dapat nating unahang solusyonan. And one of the criteria there is your social concern, which is basically asking for the perception of the community. So that is your community research phase. Okay?